So the Boolean formula here is almost always satisfied. It's satisfied in this case over here. It's satisfied in this case over here and this one. The only one where it's not satisfied is this one here. And of course, that's easy to evaluate. So if x1 and x2 and x3 evaluates to true, then we have the big not, which will make it go to 0. And 0 or 1 is equal to 1, so the Boolean formula is satisfied. But 0 or 0 evaluates to 0. So here the Boolean formula is not satisfied. And for these two cases, the Boolean formula is simply satisfied because if this goes to 0, then we have the big not over here. So it will go to 1, and 1 or 1, and 1 or 0. That also evaluates to 1. What does this have to do with an if then? Well, it's actually quite simple. If this part here, x1 and x2 and x3, evaluates to 1, then this part over here must also be 1 in order to satisfy the Boolean formula. It does not work if this part over here is 0. And in the other case, where x1 and x2 and x3 evaluates to 0, well, then, as you can see, we basically don't care what the other variables are doing because the Boolean formula is already satisfied. And that is exactly how an if-then behaves. If the condition is satisfied, then we want something specific to happen. If the conditions are not satisfied, we don't really care what happens. Or at least we're not really going to force anything to happen.